Good morning. Welcome to the forecast discussion for Tuesday, November 17th, 2020. Of course, I'm your meteorologist, Stephen DiMartino. I think you might have noticed, especially if you've already gone out this morning, that it's a bit chillier out there. Yep, a cold front has moved through, and another one is on the way, and this one is going to have the potential of producing maybe even a snowflake or two down towards the coast. Certainly already being reported over northeastern Pennsylvania around the Poconos, where temperatures have fallen off into the mid-20s to lower 30s. That's some strong cold air transport. And as you look down towards the coastal plain, temperatures generally range from the mid to upper 30s in your suburbs and lower 40s in your urban areas. Now, not everyone's going to see snow today. Actually, most people won't, especially on the coast, but do not be surprised. Even on the Jersey Shore or around Long Island, if you get some of these rain showers and you get a little bit more intense rain shower that mixes in with a little bit of sleet and snow at times, because there is a lot of cold air aloft that is moving through here. So you get a little bit of rising motion, it mixes everything up, kind of like a nice little cake, and boom. You get a little bit of snow out of nowhere, so don't be surprised by that. Here is our surface map. Okay, now here's this cold front moving through. This low pressure system will lift up towards New York City and head out into the Atlantic, and with it, a few rain and snow showers, which you could see right here. Now, again, your best potential for a few snow showers would be up towards your interior, like the Poconos and Catskills, right around this area here. Why? Because not only will we be dealing with colder conditions, but also some enhancement from Lake Ontario and Lake Erie. So with that enhancement, there is that potential for a few snow showers up here. Now along the coast here, of course, you have the cold front moving through. Cold air aloft, you get a little bit of mixing. Most of this is just going to be plain rain, but again, don't be surprised if you see a snowflake or two. On the infrared satellite picture, you can see some of the enhanced lifting showing up here in some of these showers here as these short waves are rotating through with the cold front. And you can see on the visible satellite picture, a lot of these low and mid-level clouds with some colder cloud tops are showing up as well. And the cold air is swinging on through. And notice, as the cold air is moving through the mountains and valleys here, we're getting some gravity waves showing up as well. So a lot of mixing going on in the atmosphere. When you get that, you can't ever rule out a little bit of dynamic cooling, which leads to a little bit of a surprise of a snowflake or two. So for today, watch out for an isolated rain or snow shower. Other than that, scattered cloud cover and a bit chilly. Temperatures will rise into the lower to mid 40s over the interior. Mid 40s in the New York City and Philadelphia metro. Mid to upper 40s down towards the Jersey Shore. For tonight on through tomorrow, look for scattered cloud cover with lows falling off into the mid 20s to lower 30s. For tomorrow afternoon, high pressure will settle over the region with light northwesterly winds. Look for high temperatures only in the mid to upper 30s, so you're definitely going to need a coat tomorrow. On Thursday, high pressure starts to shift off the coast. Winds start to veer to the southwest around 5 to 10 miles per hour, and so we'll start to see a bit of a warm-up, especially in the afternoon. But the morning's going to remain chilly. Lows in the mid to upper 20s. Highs will rebound into the mid to upper 40s. On Friday, a weak warm front will move through with a trough producing isolated shower or two. Other than that, sky cloud cover, much warmer. Lows in the lower to mid 40s, highs in the mid 50s to lower 60s. On Saturday, a cold front will approach but will stall out to the north of the region with a few isolated showers. Look for lows in the mid 40s, highs in the mid to upper 50s. On Sunday, we're going to have to watch the location of this frontal boundary, especially with this high pressure system, because it may introduce a stronger marine air mass than what we're thinking right now. So we'll watch that very carefully. But with this frontal boundary hanging around, watch out for a few isolated showers. Temperatures will range from the upper 30s to lower 40s for lows and mid 50s for highs. Again, if this marine air mass is a little bit stronger, we may be talking more like the upper 40s to lower 50s for Connecticut down through the New York City metro. We'll see how that sets up. On Monday, a cold front approaches in the evening with some widely scattered showers, lows in the lower to mid 50s, highs in the upper 50s to lower 60s. And on Tuesday, a secondary cold front moves through early in the morning with some widely scattered rain and snow showers, lows in the mid to upper 30s, highs in the mid to upper 40s. That is your forecast discussion for today. Of course, I'm your meteorologist, Stephen DiMartino. And as always, stay safe out there.